What is that? What is that? What is that? Oh my god! What is up, guys? It's your boy, it's Lightning here, and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're playing some Subnatica. This game is a fear factor. If y'all don't know what Subnatica is, it's a game where you get stranded. You get basically stranded in an alien planet, and the whole planet is water, underwater, surface water, all that. And it brings the deep ocean fear inside of you. And we're going to be having a playthrough. There's also a couple games I will be making videos on because the Lunar Year, New Year sale came up on Steam. And I got a couple of games, so make sure to check those videos out. And I also do have a question for y'all. If you guys do like to see montages of games, because if you guys do like to see montages of games, because I'm not thinking of good ideas for like Battle Royale games, I know the new season of Apex is coming out, so that video will be up as soon, probably a day or two maybe after it comes out. But just let me know down in the comments. Also, just a reminder, if you guys do enjoy this video, please hit that like button, subscribe to see more videos on my channel and more content like this. Comment down below once you finish the video what you thought of the video. I'd love to hear from y'all. So let's get right into the video. Okay. Ooh, cutscene. Oh. Launch in 3, 2, 1. Dang. Oh yeah, we definitely have permanent brain damage from that. Oh, no, no, no. We gotta get out. I'm gonna burn to death. Oh my gosh. Okay. Oh. Okay. Well. Booting in emergency mode. Altera, so I'm guessing that's the company we work for?
You have suffered minor head trauma. This is considered an optimal outcome. This PDA has now rebooted in emergency mode with one directive, to keep you alive on an alien world. Please refer to the data bank for detailed survival.
Should we go? Should we go through here? Yeah, let's see. Dude, I'm already scared.
Aurora suffered orbital hull failure. Cause unknown. Zero human life cells detected.
Okay, so it said zero human life signs detected. So we're the only survivors. Whoa, okay, okay, okay. So what do I do? Okay, probably, okay, so as we can see in the bottom left corner, we do have a health. We have an oxygen. We have health, we have hunger, and thirst. So there has to be a way we can find food. I'm guessing we have to take these fish. Oh, break limestone. Wait, so then what did I just get? Oh, that gave me titanium. Okay, so I can pick up these fish here. Okay, blabberfish. What is this? Gary fish. Can I eat them? Oh, look at this one-eyed peeper. Okay, can I? Oh, my oxygen's running very low. Alrighty, so let's check out our little life pod. So we have damage radio, use repair tool. Okay, so we have a medical kit fabricator. Trying to like wave my cursor. Oh, storage container. What's in here? We have flares, H2 filtered water, and nutrition bars. Oh, didn't mean to do that. So that's gonna help us. Damage secondary systems. Use repair tool. Okay, and fabricator. Oh, what is this? Did I just make water? Oh, okay. So I think the blabberfish is used to make water. Okay, yeah, let's make all that. Let's make a lot of water. And peeper, grary fish. This can all be cooked for food, I think. Yeah, cooked peeper. Alright boys, we are back and it is sunrise. Now what I'm taking. So, as I was saying, what I just noticed is there's a big fog cloud over there. Like, you can see it's noticeable. But I don't want to go over there just yet because I don't know what I'm doing. So as I learned, I think this huge ship in front of us is called the Aurora. And I think we crashed from the Aurora, which makes sense. So we are going to go down. I did make a scanner. And we are going to start just scanning just random stuff. Can I scan the peeper? Okay. Let me scan the blabberfish. Alright. So, I do not have a really goal in mind. Right now, I am just looking just to make a bunch of stuff. Just like get a base ground. Because I know there's like a little bit of story to this game. It's not like just a free roam. Our first goal is to repair our life pod. And what we need is cave sulfur for the repair tool. Depending on the name, we definitely need to find a cave. Okay, I think I found a cave. Now we just need to find cave sulfur. I don't know where to find that though. Okay, I got a new type of fish. Alright. This is really dark in here. Detecting sulfur deposits in the local cave systems. Sulfur is an essential component of the repair tool. What is that? What is that? What is that? Oh my god! Okay, well, that's fun. Oh my god, there's another one. Okay, those little things give you cave sulfur. Dude, those things were suicide bombers. Oh my gosh. So I think we did get everything we needed. So, equipment repair tool. Yes, okay. Okay, so this is the repair tool. Alright, so let's repair these things right here. As you can see, it's putting itself back together. Oh, okay. The light's turned on. Let's turn on the radio to see if we have a message, and we do. Let's replay this message. Okay, so if I got that correctly, distress signal receive, rescue operation will be dispatched to your location in 9999 hours. So they're not coming for us soon. Oh my gosh. That's not good, honestly. That's gonna take like a minute for them to get over here, or whoever's rescuing us. Okay, so I've been swimming around for like a good 5 minutes, and I think I found a crash site. If I'm not for sure, hold on, let's go for some air. If I'm not for sure, This might be a crash site. What is that? What is... Oh my gosh. What is this? I see it. I saw it. It was small. It is a beacon fragment. So if we collect two more... You do not see me, buddy. You do not. Oh, he's picking a metal. Okay. Well, we need to look for another beacon fragment. I think they might be in these little boxes. I do not know. Oh. Oh, a sea glide fragment. And I think we can also scan this counter right here. Oh, another sea glide fragment. Oh, and I think that got the blueprint for the sea glide. I don't know what that is, though. Bro, the noises this game makes is the... I am not tripping balls, am I? What is that in the distance? Hold on, let me put down my... Bro. That is the most scariest thing I've ever seen in my life. Okay, so the sea glide just got added to my blueprints. So we need a battery, we need lubricant, and we need copper wire. I think we can make copper wire right now. Battery, not so much. And lubricant. So we need more of the creep vine seed clusters. So I'm gonna wait until daytime again, and we will make our sea glide. Okay, so I think we did get everything. Oh, our water's low.
Vital signs stabilizing.
Okay, well, make more water. All right, so what did we need again? We need lube and a battery. Quantum detonation.
Is essential in construction of vehicles and power plants. The sea glide will increase your effective exploration range. For your safety, please pack supplies for long journeys and stay within 5 kilometers of the nearest life pod or habitat.
Okay, wait. Oh, this is beeping.
Receiving re-recorded distress call back.
This is Life Pod 3, uploading our coordinates. We're plugging some holes in our emergency sea glide, so if we're late for the rendezvous, don't panic. Also, don't go home without us. Seriously. 3 out.
Okay guys, before we get into that, we are going to have to stop it right here. And if you guys did enjoy this video, please hit the like button, subscribe today to see more videos like this and more content on my channel. Comment down below what y'all think about this game if you have played it before. And I just want to give one note, even though this game is very scary, it is beautiful in a way. Honestly. Just seeing birds fly, just hover above me. Yeah, wonderful. So as I said, I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.